It's weird because last night, like, I was telling Casey that, like, I can't concentrate on anything else but that moment that you guys just saw. Like, this is incredible. I want to thank my coach, Brandon Kerrigan. Thank my beautiful girlfriend for sticking through with me this whole time. If I do end up center stage, I probably will start crying because this is a lot of work, man. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a while. I think it's been about a week at least. We're here in Orlando, so I'm gonna give you an update on a couple of things. We're here in Orlando. I'm about to compete in 2 days. It's Thursday. We compete on Saturday. We're actually about to head to check-ins, where we're gonna first work out our last workout of our entire of this 8 month, what seems like forever, prep. Checked into our Airbnb on Tuesday, and I've just been kind of chilling, playing the PS5, relaxing, eating, chilling, all that stuff. Sam just got in today, so the content's about to take a level up. We got Brandon, Coach Hare, Russell Hustle Harder Team, Rubio, Casey, and we have some more people on the way as well. Just as usual, peak week is usually like the most tiring week. In my opinion, it's like the hardest week, the most draining week. But I guess the one thing that kind of keeps me going is the confidence and the feeling and knowing that this package is about to be insane. So let's go work out.
Come take a seat. Mind up the feet, I'm hungry like a man fasting this week. It's time to eat, back from the dead, but the shit on repeat. I'm the missing link, open your eyes, nigga, what do you seek? My vision complete. Nigga, we got a problem, get out the way if you ain't trying to solve it.
Let's paint it all. We in all.
everything I see, I want victory.
All right, guys, so we just finished up our last workout of the workout, the last workout of the prep. I'm extremely exhausted, extremely tired, but it's like a weird exhaustion. I'm like excited to get the show over with so I can enjoy some quality time with my family and friends. But I'm also very tired from everything that's been going on. So I'm gonna give you guys a physique update before we start pulling water. Today is Thursday. I still feel kind of flat, even though I don't look flat. There's a lot that we are going to manipulate within the next 48 hours. But here's a raw look right after our upper body circuit today. So I guess I can just... Whew. Now we go eat more. We're checking it in and eat more. Alright guys, so we just pulled up to the venue. This is honestly the most beautiful venue I've ever... It feels like we're at an airport. But definitely the most beautiful venue I've ever competed at or been to, honestly, in my entire life. About to do this check-in, see what class I'm in. I'm 6 foot, so I think the sizes range from like 6 to 6'1", 6'1 to 6'2", or 6'2 to 6'3", and then 5'10 to 5'11". So let's go check in.
First name?
Sean.
Just take this over to waivers and go from there. Good luck to you.
So it kind of looks like they pushed everyone a size down, but I mean, I don't really care. I am a class G number. Hopefully I didn't lose my number already. Number 498, just so y'all know. Number 498. So, oh, here it is. Boom. So,
what number?
498.
Oh, wow.
Like, I've heard this number somewhere.
Yeah.
Heard it somewhere. I don't know where. So,
8th my birthday.
Class G. Okay. Yeah. 9th is my birthday month, so.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And then what's 4?
I don't know.
We'll figure it out.
I need to sleep. So, that's it. I'm gonna go home and eat, and see you on Saturday. Day of the show, exhausted, did not sleep last night at all. I never sleep before a show, but I feel like these pancakes, whole eggs, butter, syrup, coffee, it's just about to wake me up. I'll be a whole different person in an hour. Check back in with me. But here's how I look this morning. I've honestly never, ever, ever woken up this dry on a show day. Like, insane. Insane. So definitely feel like we've done all we can. I think the one thing that I'm gonna make sure I do, or I have to make sure I do this show, is really nail down my posing and then get a good pump backstage. Let's go eat.
When I see you, I see blood in the water.
Alright, there's salt, pepper, ketchup, extra butter, jam, A1 sauce, and syrup. If you need more condiments, just let me know. Pardon me. Okay. Here you go. Sorry. Tabasco.
Oh, I was, yeah.
Is everyone okay?
Yeah.
Alright, enjoy. I'll be right back.
That was so good. Alright, guys, so we're back here again. I feel like we were just here like 3 weeks ago?
3 weeks ago.
3 weeks ago. So, back here doing the original. 3 pancakes. Get to offload on the syrup and 3 whole eggs, salt and pepper. Hopefully this meal wakes me up. I tried to drink this on empty coffee, on empty stomach, and it started making me feel really sick. So we're completely depleted of water, food, everything. So I feel pretty dead, but I think this is gonna be the meal that like wakes me up and gets me into that show mode. Let's go. All right guys, so we're about to do the second check-in before we eat some more food. We have quite a while. As I continue to not drink water, I feel like I'm getting drier and drier by the second. The only thing I need right now is food, carbs, maybe a little pump product, some weights to pump me up and stuff like that. Just to give you a little background of the show, last year I competed at Vegas Nationals at 205-ish, 5 to 7 pounds. This year I'm stepping on stage at around 214, 215. So I'm definitely obviously bigger. I feel like I gained a lot of size in my shoulders. My chest kind of stayed the same, but my back is what I really improved on this year. So this is gonna be really interesting when we get on stage this year. So we're about to start pumping up, getting ready. Big shows like this are always, they're hard to gauge time because they're fucking stacked with a shit ton of competitors. So honest, very good looking show. Everyone came to compete and leave it all on the stage, practice what we've gone over the past 8 months pretty much, just kind of perfecting it. Today's the day, so let's see what we do.
Myself in a hideout, in a dark space, but I'm climbing out, right now. I feel alive. Alive. I have arrived. Hey. I feel alive. I feel alive.
big house, long hallways, got 10 bathrooms, like a OG. Let's go, Tommy! And we don't want no
problems. Let's go, Tommy!
Thanks, Brian. Let's go, 498! You got this, baby! Thank you. Let's go, Tommy! 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 For 502, Daniel McGee.
Charlie is always to be better. I told him no matter what happened at the show that we were gonna bring his absolute best. And we have, y'all have seen the whole journey. Charlie was 120%. And we said the best thing that could happen would be if they moved him in the middle of first callouts and didn't move him. They moved him to the middle of first callouts and didn't move him. So finals are tonight, but it looks real good for a pro card. So we'll see. And like, dude, this is random, but I went pro in 2017. And out of all our friend group, nobody else has ever gone pro, and it'd be so freaking cool for him to be the first one. Rubio's next, 2021, not even a question. But yeah, man, this has been a dude. Corona, there's so much about this 2020, but bro, this will be the best way to end the year for Charlie Coke, for Hustle Harder, for everybody. It's gonna be amazing.
Are you going home with the card?
Everybody was big this year.
That shit was insane, bro.
Yeah, that was great.
I was just up there, just, I was like, man, you know what? I'm gonna do my best, whatever the fucking judges wanna do.
That's what it is, because there's some good guys out there.
That shit was crazy, bro.
Yeah, it was dope.
Exactly what we're talking about. Move to the center, don't move. Move to the center, didn't move.
There we go.
Thank God, man.
This shit, pro card season. Absolutely, I see you.
You have motivated me to get ready for next year, dog.
I don't think it's like it yet.
Everything you put into plan came into play. How you feeling, man?
That's how you get.
Bro, that was literally a dream come true.
That was intense, bro.
Bro, you know, like, so I was getting excited, so excited, like, my excitement was fueling my posing. And they turned back around, I was like, fuck.
Bro,
I think I might lock it. I might lock it. He was like, all right, gentlemen, see you later. I was like, thank
you. Dude, I love you. You went
above the line, bro. You had to do what you got.
That guy,
bro, the show's not done yet.
It's not.
No, because, right, obviously, we can hope. I always tell people,
bro,
is that
you're going pro. You're fucking going pro. I
always assume for the worst. I assume the worst and hope for the best. That's my thing. So right now, it's looking like the worst could be second place, which is still pro card. But if he wins, which would be great, then we got a battle for the overall. So we're just getting started. Yeah, we're just getting started.
I'm feeling
it. I'm sorry.
It's a lot.
Wow.
How do you feel?
Bro, Jose, you picked the perfect time to come.
I cried. I like my whole video.
Congrats, bro.
I had the shakes, the sweats. I had everything.
Wow.
That was insane.
But like, I don't know. I can't even explain how it felt when I was on like the stage, because in my head it wasn't processing. I was like, man, am I center right now or am I third? I couldn't tell. I tried not to focus on it.
Bro,
did you see it from?
I haven't even seen the footage yet.
Every time you went like that, I looked at the judging panel and they were just like, they were smiling, bro. They were like, yeah.
You brought it. Like, it was over. Like, nobody on the stage can beat you. That's what I'm saying. We're not done yet. Let's hope.
He's about to come in and...
Yeah, he's got to do five.
So when I come back, they just announce the winner.
You'll announce it. But if you win, you're going to stay for the overall. And that's open judging. That's open judging. So they're going to
do it. So it'll be like a lot of crazy shit, like pose off and all that shit. So we'll see.
Yeah.
All right, guys. So we still don't know the results, but it's looking pretty good. I don't like to jump to conclusions and think that I won this, won that. I definitely think it's probably a top two. I don't know. What do you guys think? Either way, top two, pro card. That's what I came for. If some miraculous way I end up in third, that'll be unfortunate, but I don't think that's gonna happen tonight. I moved to the center, I stayed there. I did my thing, man. This was a very, very, very long year, man. Like, I started prep in April, and shows kept getting canceled show after show. I think my show was canceled 2 to 3 times. I stuck through with it. I don't know how I did it, but I don't know. It's weird because last night, like, I was telling Casey that, like, I can't concentrate on anything else but that moment that you guys just saw. Like, I just can't, like, for me, the only thing that kept my mind off of it for temporarily was playing video games. Like, I bought a PS5. I was playing PS5 the whole time we were here just to kind of get me involved in something else that wasn't just me sitting down and just a movie would have got me thinking about everything else. So I spent this whole week, the last 3 weeks after the first show we did, just thinking about this show, and to see all of it just come to life, it's honestly unreal. It hasn't settled in yet. Like I said, I don't want to jump to conclusions. We still have some work to do. We're gonna go home, eat a clean meal, get ready and prepare like we're still doing pre-judging for the final show. I want to come looking better than I did for pre-judging, now that I have more time to eat and kind of play around with some things. So, man, This is incredible. I want to thank my coach, Brandon Kerrigan. Thank my beautiful girlfriend for sticking through with me this whole time. Damn, it's crazy, but it's been a long 8 months, man. Shit, but.
A lot of hard work.
You know what's crazy? Yesterday I was like, if I do end up center stage, I probably will start crying, because this is a lot of work, man. Like, a lot of work. So, man, I don't know. All you guys that commented on my posts and shit, like, and, like, gave me, like, the extra motivation, Rubio, for being here and making sure I didn't forget certain shit. Because I forgot. I almost forgot my whole life. The most important thing is coming to the show, so... I don't know, this is emotional for me because I have been doing this for a long time. I've been doing this for like 8 years, and this has always been the goal for me since I first started doing this in 2013. So we're in 2020 now. That just shows you what long, hard work and commitment can get you, and it's been a long time coming. So let's go eat.
You'll take deck, don't wreck. Head banging in the Tesla, that's breakneck. On the road, up pretty fat. Women and fat checks.
Attention.
Last test is the truth that you ain't with Taz. Yes. Turn up the bass now, go. I need the whole earth to hear my flow.
My flow. Yeah.
Act like you know. 1, 2, 3, we been here before. I would get so dark. That gun when you get too small. Getting high in it and poor. Contact high for my that score.
Son. And let's take that fifth place award, the number 484, Isaiah Nassima. In fourth place, number 491, Christopher Thompson. Finishing in third place, number 487, Jan Lanier. Let's take that second place award in IFBB Pro Car to our runner-up, Justin Williams.
Yes, Justin!
Woo! And your winner and new IFBB Pro, give it up for Sholly Coker.
Yeah!
All right, good to go. We're going to have Charlie back for the overall in just a bit. As we move to our last class, this is Men's Physique Open Class H. All right, let's send it down to the table. Big Steve.
Thank you, Bob. Gentlemen, face the curtain. Face front. 535 and 463 switch. Come between 457 and 535. Gentlemen, face the curtain. Once more, face the curtain. Face front.
Let's go, to help the judges out, folks. Yell out the number of who you want to win. All right, presenting the first place's award is Jason Batra, Vice President of Santee Labs, and Mr. Arjun Sareen from Cooper Ventures. Line up, gentlemen. Yep, stay right there, guys. You're gonna present the first place award for the title of 2020 NPC. National Championships Men's Physique. Winner is Daniel Sosa.
This is the perfect ending to my night.
I love it.
Fuck yeah. Thank you.
Well deserved.
Thank you so much.
Woo! Get my choker, right?
Woo! Got the car, man. First place. It's a good feeling, man. Honestly, I can't even talk right now. I'm so tired. That overall champion, overall battle was like literally insane. But now we get to eat. So hungry. Oh my God. Whew. Hard work, man. Hard work and dedication, man. Hard work and dedication. I know it sounds cliche, but it's been a long ass time coming. And did it, guys. This is my goal for 2020. This has been my goal forever, but I specifically set out on this goal April of 2020. I remember the day I started, April 1st, and we officially accomplished that goal. And man, I feel so good right now. I think I'm gonna feel even better when I get home and I'm able to, I don't know, maybe when I flex and post this on Instagram, who knows? Maybe tonight when I eat, or tomorrow at Universal at Harry Potter World, who knows, when I'm having a sip of butterbeer. Either way, man, huge shout out to my coach, huge shout out to my support. I'm tired of talking. I feel like I've been saying the same thing over and over again. Sam did his thing with this video, I already know. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm gonna go show you guys what I'm eating, and then we'll wrap up the video. I'll tell you my plans moving forward. But first, let me just go enjoy this moment with my family and friends. I'll see y'all in a little bit.
What's up, baby? Got first place.
So tired. I have zero.
He's dead.
Deal, bro. Good
let me
stuff.
See, let me see. What? I have BB Pro.
That's crazy, bro. Pro.
I'm fucking tired. Yeah.
Bro, pro.
You
came. We've been talking about this for years, pro. That's crazy.
It'll settle in tonight when I'm eating, man. Right now, like, I need to go like drink something, bro. I need water. I have no water. I haven't had water since like yesterday.
No, for sure. What you mean?
That overall battle, like,
no, that shit was crazy. No, that was crazy. That was crazy. I saw you were getting tired.
Towards the end, I was like, man, it's done.
It's all over. It's done.
Over.
Let's get you some water, dog.
We did it.
Steak.
Since April, we're finally here. It's been a long time coming, baby.
All right, so I'm back home from my show and got the dogs with me. Missed them so much. Got King, Myla.
Hey, King.
Guys, I'm an IFBB Pro, guys. Like, I legit have a card that says IFBB Pro. Like, this is insane. Pretty insane, honestly. I think it's just now starting to settle in now that I'm back in Houston at home and I have all the trophies and stuff with me. It's pretty cool, honestly. It's weird because technically I'm officially done with the sport. I'm not done with the sport. I can't do any more regional shows since I'm a pro. My next show is gonna have to be a pro show. So whenever that time comes, I'm gonna start getting ready for that. As for right now, my goals moving forward right now are to just focus on Anaka, focus on my business. We have a pretty dope Black Friday sale with a bunch of new stuff dropping. 12 a.m. Central Standard Time Friday, or I guess you could say Thanksgiving at midnight. So midnight tonight, Thanksgiving, today's Thanksgiving. We have a bunch of new stuff that's dropping. Give you a little sneak peek of everything that's dropping in here. Just a ton of new gear, ton of new merch. This is probably my favorite item from this launch. This new hoodie that we have dropping, tie-dye hoodie we have dropping. We have this black hoodie as well right here. It has a knock power on the front. Perfect for the weather change that we're about to have. A knock power on the front. God, I'm struggling. And then on the back, it has this cool little globe with our motto on it. Pretty dope hoodie. Tons of new gear, man. I'm telling you guys, like, you don't want to miss out on this. We have this Anaka Power crew neck that's dropping as well. Just a whole bunch of new stuff. Don't want to miss out on it. So if you guys want to check that out, Black Friday, Anaka Power, up to 50% off the entire website. But enough with that. Yeah, feels good to be home. Feels good to be off prep. Feels good to be able to enjoy life. It was an 8-month prep. On and off, of course, but for the most part, I was dieting throughout the entire time. Since April, we're now in November, the end of November, and what a perfect way to end this prep with a first place finish, IFBB Pro card, and Thanksgiving pretty much the next day. So I'm about to enjoy today. Thank you guys so much for supporting me throughout this entire journey. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Yeah, I love you guys, man. I really do. And I'm looking forward to it. So I hope you guys are looking forward to new content, more content revolving more around my reverse diet, maintaining a lean physique. So much going on in my head. I honestly have to do the Black Friday website right now, and it's just playing through my head right now. But yeah, just reverse dieting, getting back to my balanced lifestyle, cardio, weightlifting, Anaka Power, my new house that we're building, my new office that we're moving into. A lot of blessings, man, that God has given to me in this year, and he continues to give to me, and I'll forever be thankful to him for that, and thankful to you guys for supporting me as well. So just wanted to wrap up this video here. About to do the Peloton before I start my day. See, that's not gonna change, man. I spent too much money on that Peloton to not use it. About to do the Peloton this morning right now and get ready to start my day. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Comment, like, share, subscribe, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Happy Thanksgiving.
It's time to move on. It's just a little too long. Ooh.